Hello, and welcome back to session 2 of this Elefront tutorial. In the previous session, we have seen what Elefront is and why anyone would use it. In this session, we're actually going to get our hands dirty and have a look at the software and go through our first exercise. It is assumed that you have already installed Rhino and Grasshopper and that you have extensive knowledge of the use of Grasshopper. So all we need to do to get this working is install the Elefront add-on. You can download it from Food for Rhino, and it is installed in the exact same way all the other Grasshopper add-ins from Food for Rhino are installed. So that should be no problem. Now that said, throughout the course you will notice that I will be using a few other add-ons extensively, one of which I would highly recommend you install right away, because it will definitely help you to get through this course in a more smooth and organized way. The other add-on is called Autograph, of which I am also the author. Autograph contains functions and tools to help you organize your canvas as you're working through creating your definitions. And it is highly useful, and I will use it a lot of times in this tutorial, so you might as well install it as well and use it. With that out of the way, assuming that you have successfully installed Elefront and also Autograph, let's have a look at what that will do in Rhino. So let's go ahead and open Rhino and start your Grasshopper session. And you will notice that Grasshopper now has a new tab called Elefront, in which you will find all of the components that Elefront has. Elefront is basically built up in a very similar or the same way all of the rest of the functionality in Grasshopper is built up. So there's a menu with tabs, and these tabs contain components, and these components you can place onto your canvas, and then you can use them in your definition. Now, speaking of a definition, why don't we have a look and see what a typical Elefront definition looks like? What you see here is a diagram indicating the typical phases of an Elefront Grasshopper definition. Each definition typically starts with referencing components from your Rhino model into Grasshopper. The second phase consists of filtering all of the objects that you have referenced from Rhino based on their attributes. And then the biggest portion is just the traditional Grasshopper script. Nothing about how you work with Grasshopper has to change specifically, because the core of Grasshopper and whatever it does, whatever it can do, will remain untouched. You can even use your existing definitions within the Elefront workflow. So that will still always be the largest portion of your definition. And the last phase of each Elefront file consists typically of baking geometry back to Rhino. So you will define geometry or objects in Grasshopper, and within the bake stage, you will basically turn them into Rhino objects and send them to the Rhino model. That is your active model in this session. With this in mind, looking at the Elefront interface, you will find some similarities. The first tab will contain all components that we use for referencing objects. We can reference by various types, and I will get into more detail later. The second tab corresponds to the second phase in the Elefront workflow, filter. You can filter by all kinds of attributes of objects. Most importantly, you can filter by user attributes. The third tab we'll get into in a second deals with object attributes. The fourth tab allows us to create annotations, define annotations in Grasshopper, and then bake them to Rhino. The fifth tab does a similar thing, but not for annotations, but blocks. And these are typical Rhino elements that traditionally are not available in Grasshopper. At least now you can use Elefront to define these kind of components. The sixth tab basically contains two components, one of which the most important one, bake objects. Then we have one more tab that deals with data tree components, and the last tab contains parameters. You will probably not use these all too much. So now that we have that out of the way, let's go have a look at our first assignment.